Hi everyone. So let's just get the remaining pieces of Kolgar out that we still can get from that last choice. And then I guess I can discuss final thoughts and just make a general discussion about the stuff. I also compiled all that text that was flashing there. We'll see if there is anything I can get from that. Okay, I don't see that choice. Just skip. Yeah, this is the one. So let's just say it is impossible. I guess it is impossible.
それはやってみないとわからないが。And
you're saying that.
少なくともお前にその自信がないなら。
After all that verbal beating of poor Riki. It's true that I've been relying on them so far and could get nothing done right by myself. Even if I failed, they would be there to cheer me up. In other words, if I failed, I would not be the only one taking the responsibility. Maybe such wishful thinking was what had kept me going until now. What does it mean to live facing forward? I was gradually losing sight of this concept. Okay.
もう一度じっくり考えてみろよ。オッケー。もういいか。あ、done what?知りやすすぎて口出しできねえんだよ。なんかよ。もっとこう、こういうのって楽しいもんじゃねえのか?つい昨日までは少なくともそうだっただろう。
Actually, it's been pretty tough on me. I don't really get it anymore myself. While we were deep in thought, Kyosuke watched us silently. Only Rin was playing with the cat, just like always. In the end, we couldn't talk seriously about anything, and before we knew it, the evening was over. The following day, during lunch, I headed over to the broadcast room. I thought it would be nice to eat lunch here.
それは構わんが、そっちの机でな。Okay.
Our conversation went on the way it always did. I guess she's acting like nothing happened. Then why don't I do the same? This way, we'll be able to keep fooling around together with everyone. Isn't it the most fun way a relationship can stand?
So I wonder now that
the romance hasn't started, maybe like this stuff to the world won't actually happen? So like, why was it a condition for that to happen? Something also to note when thinking about just trying to explain it all. What should I announce?
前に言っていただろう。もっと普通のラジオっぽく軽いトークを交えてた。Wait,
do I have to take part in it?
言い出しっぺが何を言う。Well,
it was, but...
こういうものにアシスタントはつきものだろう。どうせ誰も聞いちゃいないさ。バカ連中には伝えてもいいかもしれないがな。せっかくだ。バスターズの面々全員をゲストとして毎週招くのも面白そうだ。Oh,
nice. You're using the school's broadcast system as you please. She always makes me play a part in her crazy plans. I'm sure it's going to be a lot of fun. Jeez, okay, you can count me in. Suppose that there are things that you can only do in the now. Then even when we're just fooling around, it's an irreplaceable experience. If only such times could continue forever, that would be perfect happiness. That's why I thought that such times should never end. And here he goes, just Riki do your usual thing. And then, one day,
forever.
Yeah, okay, yeah, so that went more or less how I expected it to go.
No perfect happy ending in sight yet. Okay, maybe, yeah, I thought maybe I could just discuss some of the stuff I just noted down for myself. Which could potentially, like, I assume I won't be able to make much of it currently. So first of all, regarding the puzzle, one point in this route, Ricky said, like, after he got determined to actually try to solve this and do something about it, he said that there are not enough parts of the puzzle and he will look for something. It felt like that was still his resolve by the very end, so it feels more like a promise to like other world. It feels maybe like a promise to either other outs or whatever is expecting us in the future. Because I know there is something like a second part of the game, I guess. I'm not too sure about that. But yeah, Rick is saying he will look for something. He will look for the pieces, missing pieces of puzzle. I feel like that is something pointing not towards this route, but to other routes. Because so far, even Comrie's route, it had some parts which maybe weren't explained by the route itself. By the end, at least the one I can remember is that. That sense of deja vu Ricky had when he was riding that train. And I guess the lake itself had something I forgot already. Actually, didn't Ricky like think that that person looked like Kengo? I don't know, for some reason I have that in my mind, I need to check. But if that is that, then it's bad, because probably it was him visiting the grave of that girl, because he didn't manage. But then Ricky would probably hear about that stuff, but maybe like he missed it while he was had his hands full with comedy. Yeah, other stuff which I'm not sure I quite understand is Kyosuke's warnings. So are Kyosuke's warnings just on a surface level, just like on a like relationship advice level, or it has connectivity to whatever the hell was happening there in that strange world? Or it could be that those warnings themselves were already part of the world that Ricky was slipping into it. But no, I guess considering this ending we just got, I guess he started slipping into it like once he actually confessed and they fell in love. Yeah, next stuff is in the end, email. Something on the that Kurgai received on the phone. Question is, not only, okay, we assume maybe it came from Ricky, yeah, but from where did it came? Like, is it implication that it came, maybe there is implication that it came from another world? Because what we saw there wasn't definitely the world that we are used to. The one where little bastards came together, or maybe it is a future, or like it may be far future or far past, but I mean she's still in school, so not far future. But I'm leaning more towards a different world, then the question is, from where did that phone mail came from? Kurgaya said that it doesn't seem like my reply will get through. From one side, in case it is like she actually understands that it is other world or something like along the lines, this question is why she understands that. But it may be again connected to the future. Maybe this email is from some future Ricky or whoever who actually managed to solve this puzzle, find all the pieces, and what we are seeing is like part of like him, I don't know, collecting everyone again together. Something like that didn't happen in Comedy's route, right? So it is not like we would be getting that scene in every route. We won't be seeing that other world in every route. Yeah, also, yeah, another weird thing that didn't really get explained, but I guess it is implied, like, why Kurgaya was against Ricky going outside. I think, okay, she did that rule after they confessed to each other, after they confirmed that they're loving each other, so we assume that the changes the irreversible changes already started happening. And considering we know that Kurgaya kinda knew what was happening with the world and stuff, I assume, like, the most reasonable explanation I can come up with is that she was trying to prevent him from realizing, either from realizing that this is some kind of loop dream world, or actually preventing him from collapsing it. Maybe those two are one of the same. I don't know. Yeah, so those are just things that I noted for myself, but let's just also look at the lines, yeah? Some of the stuff here. I tried combining them as they were appearing. I think I got it right. So we don't know who is the like speaker here, and we don't know if there is just one speaker or if there are multiple speakers. But for some reason I feel like that this might be someone we don't know, or somebody we know but from other, I don't know, plane of existence. So I wonder where it all started. I'm sure no one else even saw it begin. So something had started, and that something involved a lot of people. Because it's not just like some kind of personal phenomenon, but it included a lot of people, which didn't notice that something started. Okay, there, like, it repeats over and over again. That's something that repeats over and over again in those lines. I mean, three times, actually. Other stuff is snowflakes just keep on falling. Yeah, snow again. Like, I don't know what is the significance of snow, but here it says never to stay on the ground, just falling. They are dyeing the world white. They are coloring everything white and white again. So again, connecting to the theme of something looping over and over again. I guess the snow is kind of indication of that. I mean, I guess painting everything with white is associated with, like, just erasing information, I guess. Just bleaching everything. Just restarting it all again. And it's also, I feel like, connected to this part. It repeats over and over again. Words alone keep piling up, growing ever higher. But they will neither become a story, nor even gain a shape. So that may be connected to, like, the snowflakes being words. So yeah, like, words in general, in some visual novels, like, for example, in Tsubakibe, at some point, they used words to just specify, I guess, like, this kind of transient information, like, this radiation of information all constantly going everywhere. If we talk about, like multiple people, society, and so on. But if we talk about personal stuff, just the inside, inner world, then I guess it could, symbolize just connection of the author of these words with just thoughts in their head. So just information and words and thoughts keep piling up, but not sticking, not forming a cohesive shape. Another part is... no one knows length of their time and where they are. It is the same for everyone. I never thought the world to be so uncertain. This seems like something more personal. About the length of their time. Like the theme of death and just existing and so on. And the world not being so uncertain. So I guess that means that this concept of dying and existing, for whoever wrote this, it became uncertain, it became something abnormal in some way, not following the usual rules we would expect, I guess. And then this big part, I have a story I love, I know everyone else has one as well. However, after the story was over, why did this story have to end, I asked. Thinking of it, I felt so lonely. So I decided to add my own lines to the story. But this time, I realized I now had to end it myself. There is no story that lasts forever. Once you realize you're watching a dream, can the end of the story be far behind? Yeah, this is also something interesting. So, adding your own lines to the story, and just the notion that somebody who was sad that something was over, decided to create this something by himself or expand it, but then realizing that it eventually has to be over. And then at the end it says that once you realize you're watching a dream, you can the end of the story be far behind. I'm not sure what exactly it means here. One interpretation I have is that if you're not like writing or reading story, but you're like already watching a dream, then that means that the story has ended already and you're somewhere else. It might be connected to the theme that they are saying that they decided to add their own lines, but actually the story already ended and what they are adding is just a dream, something like that. And also about Alice and Dorothy, that they were all alone when they returned back to where they belong. Alone must I also return. So some kind of interloper, adding lines to the story, but realizing that eventually it has to end. So yeah, that is basically all I really wanted to think about and just analyze for myself before I go into the next round, which will probably be, say, Goose's round. So after something as serious, something that unexpectedly became very serious and mysterious in Kurogaya route, now I guess I'll go to Segusa and just have my ears blown away or something. I'm sure it will have sad stuff too, but for some reason I feel like it won't have the same stuff as Kurogaya's route had, but like, who knows? At this point, yeah. At this point, I'm not too sure about anything. Little Busters proved that it can really, like, just surprise me with that kind of content. So yeah, this will be a short video, and the next one I will be going for the next route, just going through common again. I assume, considering we saw all the Kengo scenes, there won't be as much of a new content. Just all the new content with the character I will be choosing. So for now, thanks for watching, and see you next time.